has come to our attention that a mysterious force is loose somewhere in outer space.
The mysteries of creation are there.
Up in the sky?
Up in the sky.
The moon and the planets are there. And new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Welcome to an edition of Tap Fishing. It's not really fishing, it's more boat maintenance. Been meaning to do a video with all the drought, the water restrictions. I've come up with a method to try to save water, if not reuse the water. So what I normally do, I pull the boat up, I put a brick under the tire, take everything out, and then I flush the engine for 5-10 minutes. So as you can see, I've got it's usually empty. I put the earmuffs on, turn the hose on, and all the water that comes out of the engine, except for the spitter that will go into the garden to water the plants. And as you can see, Amelia's touching the water. Two purposes. It actually keeps the gearbox nice and cool. It doesn't overheat. Generally, I noticed before when I was flushing the engine, the gearbox got really hot always. So now it's submerged in water, keeps it cold. Now that water is done now, so what I'll do, I'll turn the boat off. And then I'll turn the tap off, or Amelia will turn the tap off.
I'll turn it off.
Yeah, that's it. Righty tighty. That's it. Keep going.
Done.
So what I'll do with that water, I'll actually put on the grass. So rather than going in the driveway into the stormwater and wasting water, as you can see, a little bit of water spillage, but not much. I'll empty that, put on the grass, and maybe use some of it for a bucket when I wash the boat, like wet the boat down. So what I generally use to flush engines all the time, it's a product called Salt Away. Okay, what you do is you flush your engine, normally with fresh water. Yes, every time. I do it every time, my daughter's saying. Every single time, no matter what, how many times I use it or during the week. I flush, so I use Salt Away. Now it comes with a applicator, or whatever you want to call it, a nozzle. A special nozzle, okay? Which attaches to the hose. It's got three settings.
It's raining.
That's your normal wet water, and then when you want the bubbles. So what you do is you let it run in the water. And you press the applicator for the bubbles. Okay, so what I'll do now, sorry for the noise, but can't help it. I already flushed it with fresh water. So now I'll click over. And now the applicator is putting in the Salt Away. You wait about 30 seconds. So when this starts frothing here and froth starts coming out of there, pretty much you know when to shut the boat off. And so there'll be basically only Salt Away inside. So you can see it's starting up now. Starting to get some suds in there. Gets all the way in the gearbox, the back here, all the way through the system. See it flooding out here. Yeah, so we know that it's all Salt Away in there now. There's no fresh water left in there. Or salt water, hopefully. So we'll turn it off. Off. Now we just get the salt away. All right, it's obviously still, it's mixed up with water too. It mixes up and shoots out. So we'll attach the hose. It's a normal hose setting.
I'll give you one.
Okay, which is normal. Let's make sure it's clicked in. We'll put it onto the on the suds. So it's on the suds now. And just hit. Oh. The right setting, that's it, that's the one we want. Spray everywhere, all where the salt water gets in, all in the gearbox, all under here, inside the back. A lot of the salt gets caught up in here, gets caught into here, up in here, and the bolts underneath you generally get rusty. Alright, so give it a good hit. This will basically is like that the foam wash that you use for the cars. You let it sit there for a while, spray everything down. Okay, the whole boat. Alright. A good spray. Wheels, everything, windscreen. As much of the trailer you can get. Spray. Okay. Get inside here. Go to the other side now. And then all your tubes to all under here. See that? All under there. Down inside. That way, get all the salt out as you can. And it does help as you spray a bit inside the boat itself. In these tubes here, there's holes at the bottom. So when the, I don't know why they've got holes, but they wouldn't be sealed, no idea. If anyone knows, let me know. I'll spray salt away up in these breather holes. There's one here, one in the middle, one at the end. And there's one on the other beam too. And I'll spray it up in there, let it sit. And yeah, so hopefully that will help. I think anything will help. And a little bit will help. Salt is the devil of a boat and a trailer. So with the salt away too, you can spray your rods. Does not hurt your rods whatsoever. Okay, get right in there. All right, make sure you loosen the drag every single time. I've been doing this for I don't know how many years now, so I haven't had any gear fail on me. All right, I'll get a bucket of water after this, once I let it settle, and just wash the whole boat down. Bit of a rinse. Obviously, I've got no grass area to do it on. I'd love to have a nice big grass area to do it, to have some water, but majority of it's going down the grass over there anyway. So for those greenies, I'm not really wasting that much water. And that salt away, far as I know, is non-toxic. So it's biodegradable. And it's a green product apparently, so it must be natural as well, which is good. Well, at the end, once the boat's all dried off, I'm trying to be environmentally friendly as well. Again, I like spraying the boat trailer down for the rust, to prevent rust too. So all those cavities and tubes and pipes inside, I give it a hit with this Lennox. It's a natural product. It's actually made from lamb's wool, or the oil from the lamb's wool, and that won't hurt the environment. So if you do, obviously your trailer will go on the water. It doesn't pollute it because it's natural, it's biodegradable. There's absolutely no chemicals whatsoever and it's all natural. So it actually smells like, if you know, remember going to the Easter show and going to the stock area or the sheep, that's what it actually smells like, the sheep. My wife always complains the garage smells like a farmhouse, but it does prevent any rust on the trailer. So I'll spray everything. I'll spray the brake, or not the actual cut, not the actual disc, but around the brake calipers. Under the tray, all the rollers, I'll spray the rollers. The front winch, I'll spray it with this. It doesn't rust like, it doesn't come off. It's obviously not like WD-40. WD-40 is chemical based, so I don't like putting the polluting the water too much. So that's a good idea. So that's what I'll end up doing. See if I can get some film of me doing it. I'll see what happens. But yeah, every single time I do the same thing over and over again. It takes me about an hour and a half. So. Have any questions, please put questions down the bottom if you have any questions on it, or you want more videos or more detail. I'll see if I can film more of it, and we'll go from there. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.
Fabric. 1, 2, get down! Paid the cost to be the boss.